in Wisconsin. We mentioned this at the top of the show. A deadly gas main explosion rocking downtown Sun Prairie overnight. NBC's Ron Mott is there. He's got the latest. Ron, good morning to you. What a scene.
What a scene indeed. Savannah, good morning to you. We're actually at a staging area about a half mile south of where this blast took place last night. Officials are still working that scene. You can see the Red Cross on the scene here as well. In the meantime, sadly, we've learned this morning that at least one firefighter has been killed. This morning, a community rattled after an overnight gas line explosion in a small Wisconsin suburb, killing one firefighter.
For a gas leak. We just had a building explosion.
Authorities say contractors were working in downtown Sun Prairie, about 16 miles northeast of Madison, when they struck a natural gas line. Witnesses reported smelling gas not long before the powerful blast, sparking massive flames and sending thick plumes of smoke into the air. The explosion leveling at least one building, damaging several others, causing evacuations of businesses and homes within a half-mile radius. Police say while teams perform a search of the fiery rubble, there's no timetable yet for when people will be allowed back into the evacuation zone.
As soon as we can get the fire department get in there and get that ventilation, get the gas completely ventilated, and get those fires out, we can start making a determination of when we can allow people back in their homes.
Officials confirming this morning several firefighters were transported to the hospital.
Six firefighters who were transported to the hospital, three with minor injuries and released, one with a minor injury and was admitted, one who is still in very critical condition, and one who succumbed to his injuries at the hospital.
A neighborhood shaken by an unexpected tragedy.
Now, this scene, as we mentioned, is still active. We're about a half a mile away from there. Officials are continuing to work that area because they said a lot of that gas that was released ran through sewer pipes underground, and they want to make sure all that gas is out of that area before they start allowing people back into their homes and businesses. Savannah, hold up.
All right, Ron Ma, what a night. Thank you very much.
Now to a story of survival that is getting a lot of attention. This one happened in Alaska.